Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 32, the Soften and Sharpen Brushes. Now, I'm not going to lie to you, I don't like these brushes all that much. You know, there are a lot of tools in here that seem good and may even come in use somewhere along the way, but I just, every time I've used these brushes, I have not gotten the best of results. So this could mean that I'm just not very good at using the tools, and any information I give you will be lackluster. Or it could mean that the tools themselves are just bad. Always a possibility. I'll let you judge for yourself, though. So, first, what are the sharpen and soften brushes? Well, these are brushes that deal more with edges than anything else. I'm not sure how familiar you are with the basic concept behind sharpening, but when you sharpen an image, you're not actually bringing something into focus. What you're doing is you're increasing the contrast around perceived edges. So the computer goes in and it tries to find edges in your image, and then it increases the contrast to make the edges more defined. You know, it brings them out so you can see them a little bit better. This will also bring out digital noise, however. Colors that would normally be barely visible will suddenly start popping out because their contrast is increased that much. And so when you do a sharpen setting, if at all possible, you don't want to be using the brush. But that's just me. That's just me. But to see these options, we're going to have to zoom into an edge here. So I'm going to get in really close. So this is the edge we're going to be using right here along the mouth. It's pretty well defined. The contrast is pretty good. You can tell where the lip ends and where the grasp begins. Fairly simple, but first we're going to start off with our soften brush. It's right here. It's this vague gray circle. Now what the soften brush does is it does the exact opposite of the sharpen brush. It actually smooths out edges and decreases contrast. So if I start going across here, I'm just going to take a few brush strokes to really get the effect visible. Now this is at 100% opacity. Like other brushes, the opacity is the strength setting. Oh my goodness, I was wrong. I'm sorry. I am so sorry. That was not at 100% opacity. That's 100% opacity. I'll stop that. Thank you. Okay. Just and it creates a blurry edge effect. Now, you probably can't see the difference, so I'm going to quickly go ahead and undo all of those using my history palette. See the difference there? It was well-defined. Now it's very blurry. It's blurring into everything. In fact, this part of the grass is not matching up with the rest of the grass. So that's what the soften tool does. I'll undo all that again. Let's bring up a sharpen tool. Technically speaking, you should be able to sharpen an area that you have smoothed out, but I don't know. These tools are very extreme changes half the time, so it becomes hard to determine. Right. You see, this is what happens when you use the overuse the sharpen tool. I mean, look at that. It just keeps finding new lines and increasing contrast. You can see all the digital noise. Those lines are just really black and ugly. You don't want to overdo it with any of these tools. So, you know, get your line and get it quick. That's the best suggestion I can make for these tools, is use them sparingly. And get in and get out if you're going to use these. Because otherwise they're really going to start distorting portions of the image. Now they're not bad. I mean, I can bring out certain details like these holes in the face. Pretty nice, but sometimes I may just want to keep them in there. Sometimes they look better faded out. I don't know. And that's the Sharpen and Soften tools. Step didn't really come in, but opacity for the strength and get in, get out. Make the changes small and fast, all right? Leave you there.